Hello, Howard. HU.
You go.
HU.
You go.
HU.
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 You go.
Congratulations. God bless you. God bless Howard University. Your journey has begun. Let's go!
This is a work of
Saunders, Mr. Howard University 2016.
What's the best part about Howard Homecoming?
Bro, honestly, it's the vibes, bro. Like, when you look around, it's all beauty, success. Like, everybody's doing their thing in their own way. And for alumni specifically, you come back and dwell on all your successes, bro. It's beautifier.
I know you're having a good time, so I'm gonna keep it brief.
Yeah.
My last question is this.
Yeah.
What is your favorite Howard Homecoming memory?
Honestly, bro, it's a lot of shit, but it has to be my year when I was Mr. Howard. I was on the field, bro. That picture me and my queen took was on the Howard University page for 3 years, bro. That shit was beautiful.
All right, bro, it was a pleasure. Have fun, stay safe.
Yes, sir, you too.
I'm gonna see you later, let's go.
All right, gang.
Homecoming at an HBCU is more than just a homecoming. It is a family reunion, a block party, a cookout, a kickback, a fashion show, a festival, a Black Power rally, a revival, an oasis of physical and spiritual baptism in blackness.
Yeah, I heard.
Huh?
See this? We're on the street.
Okay.
Just shut down the whole block. Burn the street.
An interview with DJ Swerve, one of the most exciting DJs from when I was a student at Howard University.
DJ Swerve.
Hey, man, it's the Flo, goddamn Swerve on your ass. Yo, DJ Swerve, man. It's my dog, man, from the A to the U, to the U.
Who was the best performer in ever at Howard's homecoming?
Drake.
Drake?
All right.
Bitches, what is your favorite
Howard
homecoming memory?
The party we threw 2019, Bison by the Sea. That whole weekend went crazy. Bison by the Sea, we threw a party called Bison by the Sea, 2019 homecoming. She was a movie.
Start, let me explain what an HBCU is. It is a historically black college or university. There are over 100 HBCUs, but it's safe to say Howard University is number one. That's me on the motorcycle, Kalechi Okoro. Me and my team of friends will be your host for this movie.
Gave me five names and we just went over the five, but I'm an athletic filmmaker and entertainer.
Do you think you're coming back to Howard for another video?
They'd have to offer me a contract next time. But I'd accept it.
Homecoming for Howard University is a week packed with exciting events. So far, we've covered a few, and we have some more excitement coming soon. This is the lineup of events.
Mind when you think about Howard Homecoming?
I think about the performances, the positive energy. I think about celebrities. That's it.
What's your favorite homecoming memory?
When I met DaBaby.
Who do you want to see perform at Yardfest next year?
That's a good question. Future Hendrix.
First time at Howard, which was actually pretty cool. The homecoming, the concert wasn't as lit as I expected it to be, but overall it was pretty chill. A lot of things out there. The night ended pretty gnarly for the kid, but honestly, yeah, Howard was the vibe. I felt with the vibe and the energy. That was just like some real, like, I felt loved. Like, literally, we got into the cafeteria, and then when we got into the cafeteria, like, the lady let us through. It was just like all love, like.
What's your favorite Howard homecoming memory?
2019.
What happened?
I live in Columbia Heights. I woke up, I thought he had music in my shit. I walked over here, Baby was over here, Gunna was over here, all these old performers. I'm like, oh, this shit lit.
Thank you.
What was the best part about Howard Homecoming?
Finally, I get to answer this question. The best part for me was the energy. Just the people being there, the amount of people, the vibes, people, like, you know, you like to say. But yeah, I just say the energy overall, the atmosphere type, for sure.
How did you hear about Howard Homecoming?
Hearsay. Like, just word of mouth, people talking about it, and it's a lit event, so everybody knows about it. Especially if you live in a DMV, you have to know about Howard Homecoming. There's, like, no, like, come on now. So, yeah, shit was cheap. Word of mouth, though. It's not what you know, it's who you know, so.
What message do you want to give to Wayne Frederick?
I would like to tell Wayne Frederick, you're doing a great job, keep it up, and let's change the future. Let's get it.
How did you meet DaBaby?
That's a very interesting story. So AJ Calloway from 106th and Park, the host, the TV host, he and I had met each other earlier that day. And we bonded. We were both on similar frequencies and we were just on the same energy. And then he invited me into his entourage. And when I'm backstage, everybody's backstage. It's like, you're not just seeing one famous person. You're seeing like 50. And they're all respected in their own lane. And I was in that pool. It was like a swimming pool, but we're not swimming. We're just mingling. We're networking. It's a network. Yeah. So it was a bunch of people backstage. I remember meeting Dave East. I met Rotimi. I met, who's that other boy? Tristan Wilds. Who else is that? There's a lot. I published a story somewhere else. You gotta find it. But I met a lot of celebrities, and DaBaby was one of them. I walked up to him. He's met him. I asked him for a photograph. The first thing he said was, "No pictures." Okay. I asked his manager, "Can I get a picture with DaBaby?" I don't know. I wasn't even thinking straight. I just asked his manager, and this band manager didn't just offer me a picture. He offered me to perform on stage with him. I just looked at him like, "Whoa, what's going on?" But here's the kick. Before I asked DaBaby for a picture, I had given my cell phone to some random person to take the picture. And this person had the photographs of me and Diamante Harper, sweetie, or Tristan Wilds, Dave East, who else is there? And AJ Calloway. I hadn't published him yet. He had the camera. And at the same time, someone had just offered me an opportunity to perform on stage with DaBaby. So there's a dilemma here. And then I run with him backstage as fast as I could. Let's go perform on stage with him. We end up in the back room, which is Founders Library. We run up in the host, his own VIP room. No, it was a private area. There was no one in there at all. It was just him and me. And then DaBaby. And then the first thing I tell DaBaby is, I'm so proud of you. And then he's like, wait, what? And then I ask him, can I hand you my card? And he's like, what do you do? And then I tell him, I'm a great artist, just like you. He doesn't say anything. And then I remember the phone that had all the memory and had all the details on it. It was in the hands of a stranger. I was like, whoa, I gotta go. That's the last thing I wanted to do, but it was the responsible thing that I had to do. I had to run away from him and get my phone back. And then I ran out the building. I found him. He was still standing there. Grabbed my phone. I secured the bag. I got all the pictures. Came back. And then me and DaBaby performed on stage. It was me and some other Howard student. His name was Jerome Hamilton. He performed on stage with DaBaby with me too. And there was two other people that I forgot. But it was four of us that met DaBaby that day that were not affiliated with his billion-dollar baby brand.
I will.